Joining us live is Dr. Chima Onoka, medical practitioner. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
The WHO has said COVID-19 may never go away. How do you interpret this?
It's actually what for us. So saying that it means we need to get ready to like live with it. You know, when you have something that you have to live with, that's where we, I think it's a fact. It's a fact, basically.
Okay, the numbers are increasing. Should there not be a way to move on with life while trying to curb this spread, as the world seemed to be doing, but a little shakily at the moment?
You know, more than 3 weeks ago, I had written in the papers and the dailies about our preparing for the inevitable. That's almost a month ago. That's actually what that meant, that the way, the pattern that we're seeing, we just needed as a country and as states to prepare for that inevitable, to get people ready to get back a bit to their lives. It's not normal lives. It's a different kind of normal. And to do what we can to slow transmission, and then to manage, you know, as many people as may have it. But that's really what it means. You know, how do you live with a pandemic? Because that's the reality that we face. How do we live with a pandemic the way we live with other flus? It's not like the other flus, because transmission is much higher, and the mortality is much higher as well than some other things that we regard as flu. But that's where we are, and we need to prepare, you know, to live with it, at least for some time.
More testing is being done, more numbers are coming in, more deaths too. But what remains unclear is what happens to the dead. What is the procedure for burying COVID-19 patients who die?
I think NCDC and, you know, there are guidelines that are out there for it, especially the one of making sure that there are few people that are there. Those are the important things. Few people, so that the people themselves are not the ones transmitting it. And then you don't have the dead body, assuming it's serving now like a fomite, meaning, a body that can, you know, if there are droplets, people can pick up. As long as you don't have that, then you're good to go in terms of burying the dead. I think we should, it's actually impacting on our cultures and the things that we are used to, how we do things, the celebrations that go on with that. It's really like redefining a lot of things, and it's important that we don't lose the moment. We should, you know, kind of embrace it, to use that to redefine our value systems, redefine how we handle things, you know, the seriousness that we approach things with. It should redefine how we plan our system entirely. It should redefine, you know, how we see life completely, and so that we can focus on essentials at this time and start working on other things that are important here.
So what's your take on the sustainability of the relaxation of lockdown across board, not just in Nigerian states, but in other countries?
People, you know, the countries are trying to, you know, where those decisions are like, do you like, you know, you just mentioned in Borno, where for them suspension is indefinite. In reverse, suspension is definite, you know, more like extended up to Sunday, from what I gather, because of the social pressure that they, you know, the government noticed yesterday, that really people couldn't even get what they wanted to get. So those decisions, and that's the same thing that is going on, you know, with different countries. Those decisions are context specific. I think increasingly we'll have, you know, increased time that people have, but that, you know, for people to move around, to do their work and to live a bit of their lives and contribute to the economy. You know, but periodically there might be, as numbers escalate, you know, out of fear and out of, you know, the facts, there might be the need for lockdowns to happen again. But the interstate travel is an issue. And I think we also need to find solutions to it, you know, because people are tied up even within the country.
All
and
right,
we need to move. There needs to be some movement, but it needs to be with a lot of control as well.
Thank you very much for joining us on the news.
Thank you very much. Yeah.